Hey everybody, welcome to Dynamic Mobility through Myofascial Sequencing. I'm Shaun Hartman, and this is the fifth installment of this series for Dynamic Mobility. We started with working into our foundation. That session is called The Root. We work into our lateral lines, everything that ties the front line, myofascia, or fascia for short, to the back line. And then we moved up into the deep inner lines of the thighs, on into the deep core, and the support of the hips. Then we moved on up into kind of the solar plexus strength and tied that into the front line meridian. Then we moved into, last week, the work of our most important muscle, our heart. We kind of focused there a little bit and tied that to the back line fascia. Now this final installment through the fascia meridians takes us into the spiral lines. These are these double helix shapes that wrap around the body, and they make movement possible for, these are our most important lines for athletic movement. If you think of like swinging a tennis racket, or throwing a ball, or cutting one way or the other quickly, all of this happens with this kind of twisting motion. So we're gonna work on that today. I won't go too much more into detail on that. There's lots of good research and documentation out there about how fascia is such a vital part of our body. We're gonna start by warming up into that, conditioning into it, and then move on into a full body strength, a little bit of cardio, a nice vinyasa flow. It's all here. So let's get to it. I'm going to make sure we've got our music correct and we'll get after it. All right, let's get to it. Switch one more thing here. All right, I'm back. Okay, we're gonna start this off with a simple twist, okay? So just all from the upper body, this is where we really get to feel those spiral lines. Just a simple twist side to side. I like this because you really start to feel your back open up a little bit too. We tend to get all of this restriction in the low back from sitting a lot. Just all that compression and this kind of twisting really opens us up. We'll do a few more like this and then we're gonna add to it. What the sensation that you're looking for here is right when you get to the extreme, when everything gets really tight and starts to kind of pull you back to the direction you came from. That's the rebounding action we look to know that we're conditioning into the fascial layer. You can have hands at a fist or hands open. We're gonna add the next part. We're gonna add the leg as we twist around. So you add the leg, twist all the way. You can even twist the head a little bit as you come to the other side. Once again, hands can be open or closed. And we'll just take this until you feel that sensation. If you start to get too dizzy with this, just go back to the first variation and you'll be fine there. Find a focal point that won't challenge your equilibrium so much. If you're okay with a little dizziness, just go for it. It is good to challenge the equilibrium a little bit. It makes us a little bit more stable with our balance. And you know, it just works into conditions into the inner ear a little bit. All right, let's hit this one more time each way. And now we're going to step one foot forward. The other foot can be back, heels kind of aligned. These back toes pointed one way, front toes pointed directly ahead. So we want to work into this slowly. This, we're going to start here and touch the thigh, maybe touch the knee. And as soon as you feel like it's too tight, don't go any farther. If you get to the ankle, maybe you can get to the foot. If you get to the foot, you might have access to the floor. If you touch the floor, you can start to increase the momentum here. And let's go for four more here at your highest level this time. Three, two, and one. Let's switch right out to the other side. We'll start this in the same way because it might be a little bit different. Start with the thigh, maybe the knee, shin, ankle, foot, and then maybe the floor is available. Any place you stop along the way is just fine. And then we can start to look for momentum. And let's do four more at our highest level. Three, two, and one. All right, for this next part, we're gonna come down into a lalasana. So if you can hover here, maybe the toes are lifted. If they're lifted for tightness in the bottom of the feet, that's fine too. If you can get to this point, great. If not, just take a seat here. And I'll show this level with the seat first, okay? So from seated, we're going to just drop our legs to one side, come back center, drop our legs to the other side. So it just kind of becomes this kind of windshield wiper action that we can take one way and then the other from a seat. Or if you can lift up in the middle, maybe with hand support, you can support yourself down one way, lift down the other way. Maybe you can release the hands. I see toddlers fall like this when they're learning to walk. They'll just go straight over right like this. And I'm not quite there yet with my knee and hip mobility, but it's getting closer every time I do something like this. So I still support with my hands, but you might get to the point where you can take it all the way over one way without the hand support and back up perhaps. I'm gonna stop doing that because that's a little too much for me, and we never want to push ourselves too far. We just want to repeat the action that works and then open up over time. Okay, one more each way. All right, and then we'll find our way up to standing. If you can stand straight up, great. If not, that's fine too. No worries. I'm gonna tuck a little bit of this cord in here and then see if I can zip it up and trap this guy in here. Yeah, there we go. All right, back to our first twist. One way, then the other. We're starting to warm up a little bit, so we can start to increase. If it feels good, take it a little farther. We're gonna do less reps this time. Let's go ahead and add the leg now. Sweeping on around, turning that leg in. If anyone's a boxer, this is a good kind of hook punch there that we're throwing. It takes that kind of athletic twist. One more each way. All right, now we're gonna go for the reach. 1 foot forward, heels aligned. You should know which place you went to last time, so go straight there. And just two more. All right, switch out to the other side. Align the heels, adjust the feet, and we're reaching down. Big spiral twist. Stretching out into all of the spiral lines. Two more. All right, we'll make our way down. If you need to come all the way, you know it, and you can just go right forward. Take the legs one side, come back center, go the other way. Repeat. A few less reps this time. Let's do two more each way. Try to keep those legs coming down gently, whatever that takes, whatever support that takes for you. All right, back up right into the first twist. We're moving now. One more time, each way. Now add the legs, add a bigger twist. You can twist the head. Two more each way. Great, make your way down. I'm sorry, we skipped the reach of the twist. So align the feet, reach down. Just two more. Switch it out, other side. Get the legs aligned and go right forward. Four, three, two, and one. Now we'll take it down to the mat. Take the legs over one way, come back center, line the other side, repeat here. Just two more each way. You can start to kind of test, you know, and see how quickly you need to bring the hands in if you're getting close. All right, let's go one more time quickly through each part. So quick twist, one way and then the other. Add the legs. Just one more here. We're doing this super fast. Get set up for your twisting reach. Do four there, four on the other side. Four, three, two, one. Now we'll take it down to the mat, drop the legs over. Just gonna go two times here each way. So just do your best. This is the last time to each direction. All right, find center, maybe shake out the legs, get ready for our next sequence. This next one's gonna take us up to standing. We're gonna work through the wrists a little bit and the shoulders all at the same time. This section is all about mobility through our big circular joints. Well, through all of our joints, really. So place the hands together, kind of in a prayer position here. And then we're gonna open the hands toward you so you see the backs of your hands. Take that on around until the backs of your hands touch. Let that come down. As we come up, they're naturally gonna come back together. All right, let's repeat there. I'll put it here on the black shirt so you can see it open. Hands together as it comes down. And we bring the hands together. Once you've got the movement, you can start to add a little more speed to it. And then, if you're up for it, you can start to take it up and down. And then maybe even behind the head a little bit. We feel ourselves working through internal, external rotation quickly through the shoulders. We're working through the elbows and we're working through the wrists all at the same time. All right, next time we go down, let's find center. Let's see if we can reverse the movement. So this time we're gonna open forward, find the backs of the hands, bring it around like this, and back together. Let me do that one more time, slowly, and then we can start to add to it. If you've already got it, just go with it. And then if you're into taking it up last time and you wanna do that again, you can do so. This one feels really good to open up through the wrist. If you do a lot of typing, that's something we really need. Some openness there in that carpal tunnel area. Prevents that horrible surgery that a lot of people have to have by just moving through the wrist and not being stiff all the time. Let's do two more up and down. Next time we find center, go ahead and relax. We're going to take both arms, give yourself a big hug around the shoulders. Lift the elbows up all the way to the top and then gracefully open up to the side. Switch which arm is on top. If you've forgotten, just know which one it is this time and remember for the next time through. We're just gonna alternate here, grabbing the shoulders, opening up the arms. And if you get off in your alternation, no big deal. But it's something worth pursuing. That kind of balance and that kind of concentration. Let's do two more each way. All right, one more to each side. Great. All right, next, we're gonna take a seat. So let's have a seat here. And we're gonna cross the legs. So as always, I'll present this in the easiest way first, and then we'll build up from there. So from cross legs, you're gonna take one arm. This will probably be your left arm coming to your right knee, and just reach across it. We wanna kinda prop the elbow here so we can have a little bit of stability. And then we're gonna take that hand down, and that's gonna twist us around. You'll feel a big twist there. If that feels like you can do more, take the left leg on top of the right if you want to go further with this. I'm sorry, this would be right leg on top of the left for this side. And we bring that elbow in to the knee, and then we twist into it. So from cross leg or this more advanced position, we're still working into the same areas. And to get to the advanced position, you need to a lot of reps in the beginner level. It's a stepping stone. Let's do four more here. Three, two, one. All right, we're gonna switch this, the twist of our legs here. So you can just switch the legs around, or if you wanna have fun with it, you can take one hand back behind, take the other hand across, and then we're just gonna turn on around until we're switched out to the other side. That should be, I didn't pull it off that time. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. We'll try it again next time. All right, so place that elbow in there, whatever position you choose, and then we're gonna crank into this twist. So be careful here, because we're using a little bit of extra pressure from this lock we have from the elbow to the knee. So just be aware. and then just go for it. Once you kind of know your limits, then you can move within them to the best possible area of openness. Three more here. All right, so now we're gonna introduce something new here. We're going to start to extend this forward leg. It can sit on the ground if you like. And let's take it from the ground first. We're gonna start to take this leg around, find this rotation through the hip as we go back. Just take it back as far as you can. You might get all the way to a pigeon position. Maybe explore that a little bit through the hips, see what you're working with there. And then bring that leg back, tapping anywhere you need to along the way. For this next one, you can continue with that or you can step it up a little bit. Maybe you can hover here. Hover the leg and then take it to the side. Maybe a tap down there if you need to leverage. Take it on around, supporting with the hands all the way to the back. And then we're gonna bring that leg back around, just floating as much as we can. If it feels like too much of a labor, then tap the leg down. Maybe we can keep the hands lifted, move all the way back into it. All right. Now we're gonna add something here. So we're gonna twist toward the extended leg. If it's down, it's down, no worries. Just add a little twist there. And then we're gonna twist the upper body around as we twist the leg back and try to move out this way. Okay? Twisting. And twist at the top. Let's do two more. Leg extended, legs going around, and we're twisting the other direction. One more time. Great. Okay, let's switch back to that first side. I'm gonna try this movement again. I went the wrong way last time. This time I'm gonna go this way, cross the arm over, twist around, and there we have that fun little twist into this one. So we're back where we were the other way. We can extend this leg. Remember, you can tap down, take it low at first, see what that's like for you. Take that leg back. I'm actually gonna move this time to the other angle so you can see. We got this leg in front, and we're taking that leg on around. It ends up in the back there. Okay, let's do one more kind of practice with that and see what we got on lifting this side. All right, and then we'll try to add the twist. Twisting here and twisting around. If you need the hand support, take the hand support. We're gonna do two more. One last time back and then bring it forward. Great. All right, let's come back up to standing and we're gonna circle our wrists. Up and down like we started with. Time to step it up a little bit here again. And now reverse directions. Take it down and up. Reverse directions of the hands. If you don't get the reverse, no big deal. You'll grow into it in time. Fortunately, these are all available for you to repeat into. Week by week, you'll notice big progress. All right, let that go. Hug yourself around the shoulders. Which arm's in front? Lift up, extend. Put the other arm in front, lift. Extend, lift and extend. Let's go one more each way. All right, we'll take it back down to the mat. Let's start, either leg can be in front this time. We got our cross leg here. Take that elbow to the knee and we're gonna twist into it. Just four this time, three, two, and one. We can move on around this direction, change sides. Actually, let's not do that first. Let's do our leg lift here. All right, I'm gonna turn so you can see a little better. And we're gonna twist towards the leg. We're gonna go right into the twist, on around to the back, catch yourself anywhere you need. Very challenging, but so worth it. Two more. I'm sorry, just one more. We'll be fine for this round. Great, okay. So now we can return back to our starting position and twist around to the other side. I'm gonna turn for you here. One hand, other hand crosses over, twist it around. Here we are, take the elbow to the knee and crank into it. One, two, three, and four. Now we're gonna lift this leg. I'm gonna turn again for you to see a little better. Twist, and then we take the leg around, twist. Just three of these. Last one. All right, great. Let's repeat through all of those one more time pretty quickly now here into the wrist, take it up and down two times, reverse directions, up and down two times. Hug the shoulders, wrap, lift, one. And we're just gonna do one more here, alternating, one to each side. Great, we're ready to make our way back down. I'm gonna go with the other leg this time, just to kind of change it up. Get your right position here, get your lock in, and twist one, and twist two. Take it right into lifting the leg, twist here. Take it on around, twist to the side. Just two this time. Great, we can wrap back around where we began, and we're gonna take it around to the side. Oh, wrong way. This way is where we go, and that'll work for us, twisting the other way. I shouldn't have changed it up on you, that was a little bit much, but we got there. Lock the elbow in, twist, two, and let's do three and four. Take the leg up, twist towards the extended leg, take it around behind, twist in your pigeon. Two times. Great. Extend the other leg, relax for one moment. Let's get ready for our low body work. This one's a little different. We've done a lot of squats and things like that in the other session. This time we're gonna do some leg lifting. It'll work a different part, which will be great for us. Find hands and knees. All right, take your right hand up to a 10. Just perch up to the fingers there and take the other arm to the forearm. Okay, now we're gonna take this right leg, same as the hand that's on the fingertips, lift up the best you can, try to take it towards the elbow. You don't have to touch, but just take it towards, and then extend back behind you. Okay, in towards the elbow, and extend it back. In, and back. One more. Let's do four quick ones. Four, three, two, one. All right, now we're gonna extend the leg. We're gonna pulse right into the heel. Three, two, one. Now take that foot out to the side. Tap down anywhere you need, and then take it around, even cross the body. That's a little twist there. To the side, and across. To the side, across. Two more. One last time. Now four quick ones. Four. Three, two, one. Keep that leg extended back. Point the toe now and pulse. Three, two, one. Release that side. Let's switch out. Forearm on the side. We had to perch up to the tent with the fingers. Go the other side with our fingertips. Lift that knee up on the same side as the perched up arm there. Bring the elbow toward, the knee towards the elbow, and then extend back. And in, and back. In, one more, and back. Now, four quick ones. Four, three, two, one. Extend back, pulse through the heel. Four, three, two, one. And now we're gonna take it out to the side and across. Out, across. Out and across. One more time. Now quickly, four, three, two, one. Point the toe, we're not done yet, pulse. Four, three, two, and one. You can relax back into child's pose. Nice job, that's pretty challenging stuff there. We're gonna go into some upper body work here. We'll start from the knees. Lower down into a chaturanga push-up, elbows in. Come up, take one hand out wide to the side. Other elbow stays in tight. Take it low. Take it in. Elbows in. Now take the other arm out to the side. Take it down. All right, so you can do that, or if you want to add more to it, you can take it up to a full plank. Push up. Take one arm out wide. Push up. Narrow chaturanga push up. Wide to the other side. Good. All right, let's just do a couple there. One more in the middle. And then we're gonna add a little complex here into a side plank. So I'm gonna turn to the side for this one. Starting from hands and knees, we'll take the elbow down, the knee down, and we're looking for our side plank here, standing up with the arm, all right? And then we'll take the other forearm down, come up to the other side, side plank on the forearm. Next time, we put the hand down flat. We shift over, extend up. Other hand comes down flat into the palm, side lunge. Back to the forearm. Maybe you take this to a full side plank. And then straight arm, straight arm. Let's do one more there. Forearm, forearm, straight arm, straight arm. Great. All right, let's put these together. Hands and knees here. Find the first side, fingers, forearm, take the leg back, and then pull it in, elbow to knee, extend back. I'm gonna turn to the side on this one. In and back. Just two this time, then we'll do two quick ones. One, two, keep it back, pulse into the heel. Three, four, now take it out to the side, take it across the body. Just two here. And then hold it back, point the toe, pulse, two, one. All right, let's switch out to the other side, other forearm down, fingertips on the other side, knee to elbow, take it back, and in, and back slowly. Now two quick ones, one, two, pulse into the heel, and now take it out to the side, and across, again, side, and across, point the toe, pulse, three, four. All right, quickly to the upper body now. Chaturanga push-up, out wide, chaturanga, other side, center. All right, we're gonna go right into our forearm complex, forearm on one side, side plank, forearm, side plank, straight arm, side plank, straight arm, side plank. All right, we're into our heat section now. So this one's pretty quick and pretty tough. So let's just do our best here. We're gonna start off and find a burpee. So if that's stepping back for you onto your knees and doing a push-up and getting up, stepping into it, maybe coming to the toes here. And then from there, we're going to come down, take the legs out, look for the hip just as low as we can. This doesn't have to be super low. You're just kind of stepping here, that's fine too. Just take it as low as you can. If you come all the way down, it starts to get pretty intense. Come up here to the toes or a little hop. All right, here we go again. Extended version would be a burpee. And then into a hop. You can take the leg in front this time if you like. Front or behind is fine. Either way, it just gives us a nice stretch and it gets us all the way to the ground where we have to work. Okay? All right, let's do it again. We're gonna start to get a little bit quicker here. Get that push-up in, even if it's from the knees. Bring it up. Maybe you can lift off a little bit here. And then we'll take it, the leg behind, come low. Another hop in the middle. Take it low. I'm kind of switching off, taking the leg behind and in front. It's up to you. If you like one way better, go for it. Burpee. Little hop. Then we take it low. Hop in the middle. It's a nice addition there. And another hop brings us back to the beginning. And now we can start to move a little bit. No, we're starting to get fatigued. We're getting really close. This is about the last minute here. So this is the hardest part of the challenge. Just keeping going here. So if you need a break, if you need to modify, go for it. Otherwise, let's work. All right, burpee, hop, take the legs low, hop in the middle. All right, home stretch here, almost there. So hard to keep getting up and down, but so good for us. Burpee, hop, one side, other side. Bet we can get another one in, here we go. And that's the end. Good job. pretty difficult stuff there, but you came through like champions. Nicely done. This next flow is one of my favorites. It's very unique and it's very dynamic. We're gonna start off through each pose very slowly. That'll help us catch our breath a little bit. So we're gonna start off in sun salutation. We like to begin this way. Go back into a back bend and just hold. Anything that feels good with the arms. And then we'll fold forward. Relax here. Maybe sway a little bit. Try your best to slow the breathing. That's work in itself. Trying to relax when your body's really worked up like that. Halfway lift. Straighten through the spine. And refold. Having any success with slowing the breath down? I hope you are. It's kind of working for me, even if it's not something to be frustrated about, just something to give you some more effort to. Place the hands, you can step your way back to plank or float both legs if you're doing the burpees before. Shift forward, here's another chaturanga push-up. Drop the knees if you need. Upward dog or cobra with the knees dropped. And then we'll press on up from there into downward facing dog. And just hold here. Another little bit of active rest for us. I'm thinking I should probably turn to the other side, so I'm gonna do that first. And then we're gonna lift the right leg up and just hold it. Now we're gonna pull that knee in. Really contract it in, see how far we can get before we set it down. We're in this nice low lunge here. We're gonna extend it to a high lunge with a little variation. So we'll come up, open up the arms, take them to kind of goalpost, open up through the chest and hold here. This is where we're gonna learn the sequence, little by little, nice and slow. Here's the next move. Press the arm forward as you straighten the front leg and bend the back leg. It's gonna challenge your balance, so just be aware, take it easy. Take it slow, press forward, bend the back leg, do your best to straighten the front. Now, we're gonna open the arms up, we're gonna bend into the front leg, straighten the back, take that back leg all the way down if it will let you. Open up the chest. And hold. Now we're gonna take the arms and press forward. It's gonna help lift us, straighten the front leg, bend the back. All right, now we're gonna move like we did before, bending into the front leg, straighten the back. This time we'll open up the arms into a twist here. And just hold, work for our balance. Now we're gonna cartwheel the arms and end up in a wide leg fold here. We'll pause here for a moment. And then we'll continue to walk it on around. Now we're gonna bend into this leg. Take the back knee down, straight as we can get with that back one, cartwheel the arm up. This will be opposite arm, reaching towards opposite leg. Lift the front arm up. Hold here. Now we're gonna move ourselves through, back to that wide leg fold. This time we're gonna walk it on around. Bring the back leg up to meet the front. Again, we'll come up, find our back bend. And fold forward. Halfway lift. Straighten up long through the neck. Refold. We're gonna go through our chaturanga. You can always skip it and go straight to down dog if you're tired. Otherwise, chaturanga through. You can support with the knees too. Upward dog or cobra. Lift into down dog. Hold here. We're gonna lift the opposite leg high that we did last time.
pull that knee in, contract in. Think about your movement here. Try to step that leg forward best you can. Settle yourself here.
And open up the arms. Find that kind of goalpost shape. Open the chest here again. And just hold. Press forward, straighten the front leg, bend the back. That back leg might not bend a ton. Don't force anything. Now we're gonna bend back into the front leg. Open the arms up, straighten the back leg. Take that back knee all the way down. Open the chest. We're gonna take the arms, press up again, straighten the front leg, bend the back. Now we're gonna bend back into the front leg. Open up into the twist towards the bent knee. Straighten the back leg best you can. And now we're gonna move slowly into our wide leg fold. Take a moment here to relax. And then we'll carry it on around by walking the hands, turning the feet. Bend into that front leg. Take the back knee down. Once again, we're gonna reach that opposite arm for the back leg. Lift the front arm up. Don't feel like you have to touch. If you do, great. If not, just do your best. All right, now we're gonna try continuous movement here on into the wide leg, moving right past that to the front of the mat. Let's sweep our arms up. Bring that back leg in. Once again, back bend here. We'll cut these movements down. Just two breaths at every pose. We'll build our muscle memory into some really active sequencing here in just a moment. Halfway lift. We'll work our way up to that. Refold. Take your version of chaturanga, whatever that may be. Legs back, push up or not. Back bend or not, whatever it is, let's all take down dog. Take the first leg up high, pull the knee in, step it through. See, we're moving a little bit quicker now. Lift these arms up, open up through the chest. Press forward, straighten the front leg, bend the back. Now, we're gonna come forward again, twisting, cartwheeling the arms. This time, we're not gonna do a fold in the middle. We're gonna sweep all the way through. Carry that arm around, drop the back knee, take that arm for the back leg. Lift the front arm. We're gonna sweep through again hard. Here we go. Sweeping all the way to the front. Take the arms up, circle it around, circle that back foot to meet the front. Take it right into our back bend. Fold forward. Halfway lift. Refold. Plant the hands. Chaturanga. Back bend. Downward dog. Other leg goes high. Pull the knee in. Step it through. Take the arms up, open up. Press forward, straighten the back, straighten the front leg, bend the back. Open up again, bend into the front leg, straighten the back, take it all the way down to that back knee. Open the chest. Press forward, straighten the front leg, bend the back. We're gonna sweep through, here we go. Sweeping it through. Taking that hand for the back leg, dropping the knee all the way down. Sweep through again. Nice and smooth, all the way to the top of the mat. Lift the arms, sweep the back foot up to meet the front. We've done it again, good job. Back bend. It speeds up again, fold forward. Just one breath at every movement. Half lift, refold. Moving pretty quick now. Chaturanga or meeting down dog. First side, leg goes high. Pull the knee in, step it through, open up the arms, open the chest,
then we press right forward. Now we circle into this twist towards the bent leg, sweep it around through. We go all the way and reach for the back leg. Yes, sweep it through again. Nice and fluid. Sweep the back arm, back leg up to meet the front. Back bend. Fold forward. Half lift. Three fold. Plant the hands. Chaturanga. Down dog. Other leg goes up. Pull the knee in. Step it forward. Take the arms up. Open up. Press forward, straighten the front leg, bend into the back, and then open up again. This time, we're gonna take that arm forward. We're gonna open up all the way to the back knee, open up the chest here, reach the fingertips towards the ground. Press up again, straighten the front leg, bend the back. We're gonna twist this time, bend into the front leg, take that same arm around, twist towards that bent leg. We're gonna sweep through. This time we're gonna circle all the way around, reach for that back leg, and then we'll sweep back through. All the way to the top, arms come up, let that sweep, the back foot up to meet the front, back bend. This is gonna be the fastest one, just do your best. If you don't make it, that's fine, you've done great. Half lift, refold, chaturanga. Down dog, take that first leg up high, pull it right in, step it through, open right up there, press it forward. And then we'll open into the twist. Now we're gonna sweep it around through. Reach for that back leg. Pretty quick here, really cutting it down. And we'll take it up, sweep the back foot up. Back bend. Fold. Half lift. Refold. Chaturanga. Down dog. Other leg goes high. Pull it in, step it in. Open up. Press forward. Straighten the front leg, bend the back. Open up again. Bend into that front leg. We'll sweep it right around through. Reach for the back leg. Sweep it around. Up high. Sweep the back foot up to meet the front. Great job. Wonderful work through the flow. Feel that nice freedom of movement through the whole body. And from here on out, we'll do a little core work. Now we've kind of got ourselves heated up again. We'll end with a little bit of core because that's the most vital. And then we'll stretch. That may be more vital still. All right, so we're gonna come down. I'm gonna come down to the mat here. Straighten the front legs, give them a little shake. And then we're gonna lay back all the way down here. Take a few breaths here, breathe into the core. Breathe into the abdomen. Now we're gonna be ready to work it. Take both feet up, right? Take the hands back. I'm gonna reach up, fingertips towards the outside of the opposite foot. Take it back down, reach up to the other side. Slowly take both legs down to the ground. Take a breath. We'll make a pyramid of this to kind of lighten the load as we get in quite a few reps. Take both legs up. Get ready, we're gonna do two times this time. So reach to the outside of the opposite leg, outside of the opposite foot. One more. And again. Take both legs down. Take two breaths this time. And legs go up again. This time we're gonna do three reps. So this will be the hardest one, then we'll work our way down. So we come up to the outside and the outside of the other foot. This is number two. Two more. I'm sorry, just one more. Two more reps. One more time to each side. Lower the legs slowly, best you can. Three breaths, here we get. And we'll go up with the legs again. This time just two reps, okay? So here we go, outside. Outside, that's one again. One more. Do your best to release the legs slowly. That's a lot of strength there, just releasing down. You get two breaths to rest. Legs go up again. Just one time to each side here. So here we go. This one's no problem after doing so many. Just one more rep. Lower the legs slowly.
Take a breath. Take a couple breaths here. Now we're gonna get into the next one. So this one takes a little bit of building up to, so let me show you what I mean. We'll take one knee into the chest, okay? Just bring it in as best you can. Now I want you to feel this movement, this sensation of taking that knee towards the other leg across the body. Okay, let's feel that first. Take it across and back up. Let's do four of those. Just to kind of get that sensation, feel all that spiral core really working for us here. Now we're gonna add a little bit more. We're gonna add some resistance. So as we try to bring that across the body, take both hands and block that knee. Press into the hands as if you're still trying to go across the body. Two, one. All right, release that. Okay, there's one more level we can add here. We'll bring that knee back in. One more level, you can lift the opposite leg and hover that. Bring the knee across the body, let's hold. I'm holding a little bit longer this time. Three, four, and release, relax. Two breaths here to rest. This will be our longest one, okay? So find if you want to hover that leg and pull the knee in, you can do so, or let that heel come down. Try to twist that knee across the body, resist. Two, three, four, really press, and now release. Three breaths to rest in between. Let's go back for that first hold. Hug your leg if you want. Try to cross that knee across the body. Hold. Four, three, two, one. Release. Two breaths to rest. One more time. It's our victory lap here. Pull the knee in. Try to cross. Two, three, four counts. Extend, release. All right, we're gonna go right for the other side here. I'm gonna just switch the angle and see. Maybe that might be a little easier to follow along. Pull that first knee in, just like we did before. Go ahead and take it across the body for four, three, two, and really try to feel that spiral core working so you can feel that whole sheet wrapping around the belly there. We're gonna work into that really good. All right, now let's try to resist. So same movement, take two hands and resist the movement across. Hold, three, two, one, release. This time we can hover the opposite leg, if that feels okay to you. Pull the knee in, resist across the body. Four, three, two, one, really squeeze right there at the end. Nice controlled release, two breaths to rest here. Okay, once again, hover the leg if you like, pull the knee in, cross across the body, try to resist. It's our longest hold. Last four, three, squeeze, two, one, release. You get three nice long breaths here to rest. Then we'll go again for two this time, two counts of four. Four, three, two, one, and release. Two breaths to rest. All right, here we go. One last time. Just four counts in. Resist as you try to cross the knee across the body. And we're done. Release. Good job. Breathe into the core. Move any way that feels good to stretch that out. Notice all of the sensation in this spiral core area. All right, now we're gonna do some really nice twists to finish us out here. This part of the training is we call the plasticity section because we wanna work into this kind of like silly putty plastic nature of the fascial tissue and really get it stretched out so that it's more elastic and more open to take any kind of weight that we need to distribute to whatever area. So, let's begin just from seated here. And let's do a little windshield wiper with our knees again, like we did in the beginning, just a couple times, just to kind of loosen up there. One more. Good time. Next time you come to the first side, you can just stay here. We got a pretty nice twist going, right? You feel that? If you'd like to add more, take that ankle on top of the knee, try to ground out through that other knee. Don't have to do that. If it feels good, go for it, and then twist away from the bend of the legs. You have to hold this for about 40 seconds in each position to let the muscles let go, especially after we've really charged them up with that challenging movement from the heat section to the vinyasa, and then through the core work. Next exhale, come back center, take the legs to the other side. Once again, if you want to take that ankle on top of the knee, ground out through that same leg and then start to turn away from the bent legs. Feel that nice stretch, that nice twist. Move into it in any way, just try to keep holding it. Keep breathing into the space that the breath creates. Next exhale, release, come back center. All right, so now we can lay back. I'm trying to think of the best way to demonstrate this one to you. I'm gonna take it at from the side. Let's give that a shot. Lay back, you're gonna lift one leg up, press into the heel. And then first level, you just take that straight leg right across the body, okay? You can support with two hands. If you feel a little bit more flexible, you might be able to get a hold of that foot or the toes or maybe a little higher on the leg. Then try to straighten out through the leg best you can. If it feels like too much, bring it back down. Take it across the body. Nice big stretch. The other arm is out to a T on the side. Do your best to straighten through that leg. That'll kind of be the work of it. Don't push too hard where you feel uncomfortable and things start to try to tighten back up on you. That's the last thing we want. Try to just picture all of your contracting muscles just relaxing, melting into the pose. And next exhale, slowly bring it back center. Need to make any adjustment along the way, then do so. Release that leg down. Let's go for the other side. I'm just gonna spin around here. You can stay right where you're at. Take the other leg high. And we're just taking this one across the body the same way. You know, if you just end up like right here, that's fine too. No problem. Don't feel like you have to achieve anything. Just enjoying the stretch and letting your body get what it so needs. Bring the other foot. It doesn't have to touch the ground. Just feel the tightness through the leg, feel the tightness in the twist, and try to breathe into it. Next exhale, come back center, release the leg. All right, these next few we'll do from our belly, so we'll transfer over now. All right, first one we're gonna do, lay down and kind of press up into Sphinx pose. Maybe move through that just a bit. Take two arms out wide to the side. Take the first leg up, kind of reach through the heel, and then start to take that leg across the body. Now you may get suspended right here and you're getting just a fine stretch. Don't feel like you have to force it down. Really let the weight of the leg just take it down where you'd like to. The head's gonna naturally turn towards that extended leg. Actually, it's probably more comfortable to look the other way. And then if you look towards that extended leg, then you accentuate the twist there. So start this way, and then if you want to turn the head and add more, you can do so. Next exhale, slowly make your way back center. Release that foot down. Lift into the other heel. We're going to go right into it. Take it on across. Just wherever it feels right for you. If you want to twist the head back the other way, this one's a little more difficult for me, so challenging just a little bit here. Next exhale, come back center. Release.
Right? Now we're gonna do something very similar.
We're going to lift into that first leg, bending into it. Then, if you like, you can just start to reach over to the side with it. That'll create the stretch. If you'd like to add more, you can reach for that back foot and then take it on across. Pretty nice twist there. If you want to go even farther, you can lift into a straight arm there, lift that leg. Pretty nice twist happening there. Take it back center, slow and controlled. Bend into the other leg, and we can do the same thing here. Just bring it across first will be the first step. And if you want to add the reach of the hand, that's another level. Don't have to go there. You want to extend up through that arm, take it even farther. Lifting through that knee to create more space. And next exhale, come back center. Take your time.
We got one more we can do here.
Let's bring that first leg up again. Come into kind of like a pigeon pose with the knee forward, that back leg extended back. Then we can start to move on to this hip. Now you can choose your level here. Come to your forearms, that might be enough. Or you can start to kind of thread the needle here, looking for that shoulder. If it feels like too much, you know, go back. If it feels okay, extend, place one palm onto the other, and enjoy this really big twist here. Let every breath expand you deeper into the twist, more opening each inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to release, so use the strength of the arms to get you out. Take your time. Pull the other leg up, and again, we're extending the back leg long, and then we're turning onto this hip. Once again, this might be enough here. Otherwise, you can go forearms. That feels good. Thread that arm through and settle onto that shoulder. Place one palm onto the other, stack them up, and twist. Next exhale, we'll release from this pose. And if you have the time to relax completely and lay all the way back, I really encourage you to do so. If you gotta go, I hope that you have a wonderful rest of your day. If you're still here with me, try to let your thoughts just drift away, just kind of evaporate as they come through your mind. See if you can just release fully. And if you have enough time in your day to extend this even farther, I hope that you'll take full advantage of that. Otherwise, I'd like to thank everyone for sharing your practice with me. It's been an honor and a privilege. Namaste.